Welcome on this tutorial, wish all you are well. Series of pressure measurement technique is going on. Last tutorial I have discussed about definition of absolute pressure, gauge pressure, vacuum, differential pressure. Then I have discussed about different units of pressure and the relations among them. This tutorial I am going to start with manometer. I'll discuss here how manometer is used to measure the pressure, what are the different types of manometers, etc. Entering into the discussion, please subscribe and support me. Different types of pressure measurement technique, which I will discuss in this series of pressure measuring chapter. I'll discuss on manometer, diaphragm, Bourdon tube, bellows, strain gauge, piezoelectric, piezoresistive, macleod, Pirani, ionization, etc. In this tutorial here, I am starting with manometer. A manometer is an instrument that uses a column of liquid to measure pressure. The manometer utilizes the hydrostatic balance principle, where pressure is measured by the height of the liquid it will support. Liquid which are normally used in manometer are water, oil, and mercury. In general, mercury manometers are used and which can measure a range of 1 millibar to 1.5 bar pressure. According to construction and operation, there are different types of manometers like U-tube manometer, well-type manometer, inclined tube manometer, barometer, etc. Now explaining the operation of U-tube manometer. U-tube manometer consists of a glass tube. The shape of this tube is just like English alphabet U. The tube has two legs. This is one leg, this is another leg. The unknown pressure to be measured will be connected at one leg. The tube is normally filled up with mercury. Other liquid might be used. When no pressure will be applied, then height of liquid column in both leg of manometer will be same. Say this is the height of liquid column at left leg and this is the height of liquid column at right leg. I have shown the liquid by using this red line shade. Now while pressure to be measured is applied to one tube, it produces a movement of liquid. In this case, say pressure has been applied at left leg. So level of the filling liquid in left leg will be dropped and level in the right leg will be rising. See in this figure, the level at left leg has been dropped and level at right leg has been rising. Now what will be the height of this liquid at right leg? With the application of pressure, liquid movement will stop when the pressure exerted by the column of liquid H is sufficient to balance the pressure applied at left leg of manometer. That is, when the head pressure produced by this column H will be equal to the pressure to be measured. As now this is the level at left side where pressure has been applied and this is the same level in the right side. So here the pressure at downward direction which is due to applied pressure. Pressure at this point will be due to weight of the liquid at a height H. These two will be equal. So applied pressure, which is unknown pressure P, will be equal to H into rho into G. There will be some additional term, which is the pressure at the upper surface of this liquid column. At this moment, I am considering at this is P A if this is open to atmosphere. So here P minus PA, this will be equal to H into rho into G. So what is indicated by the term H rho G? This is the pressure P with respect to atmospheric pressure. So H rho G indicates the gauge pressure. In this term, rho is constant, G is constant. So H is only the variable. When the applied pressure will be changed, then H will be changed. That is, H is the indication of applied pressure. Now, if two pressures have been applied in two leg, say one pressure is P1, another pressure is P2, then P1 minus P2 will be ultimately H into rho into G. In that case, H will indicate the differential pressure. Here, rho is the density of the liquid which has been used inside the manometer. Mercury is one of the suitable liquid which is normally used in manometer. So, by suitable choice of filling liquid, various low range of gauge pressure can be measured, and the range might be 500 Pascal to 1.5 bar. This is how U-tube manometer works for the measurement of pressure. Well-type manometer. This is same as U-tube manometer. Exception is the reservoir on the applied pressure side. So construction is just like U-tube manometer. One leg is a reservoir, another leg is just like a small tube. This construction sometimes called a single column gauge. This well-type manometer consists of metal well of large cross-sectional area connected to a glass tube. This system normally contains mercury as the filling liquid. Both the well and the tube are open to atmosphere. When no pressure has been applied, level of the mercury in the well is equal to the level in the tube. Level at well reservoir is say at this level, and inside the tube the level is at this height. I have shown liquid level by this red colored dashed line. The level inside the well and the level inside the small tube both are same. Pressure to be measured is normally applied to the well. When pressure applied to the well, the level of liquid in the well falls, say by a distance x, and the level in the limb or tube rises by a distance h and stop the movement of liquid. This is the level of liquid inside the well, and corresponding level inside the tube is here. So the pressure applied at this position will be equal to the pressure applied at this level. Here the applied pressure is the pressure to be measured, and here the applied pressure is the pressure due to the height of the liquid h plus x plus atmospheric pressure if this leg is open to atmosphere. So column of liquid h plus x exert a pressure which is equal to the pressure applied at well. This height h plus x increases while pressure to be measured increases, and this h plus x height decreases while pressure to be measured decreases. So this value of h plus x or h is the indication of applied pressure, and this h plus x or h can be read from a scale which is positioned like this diagram. This scale is calibrated in units of pressure like millimeter of Hg, Pascal, etc. Now, what is the mathematical relations related to this well type manometer? The volume of liquid which is decreased due to the application of pressure in oil will be equal to the volume of liquid increased in tube side. Now the area of cross section of oil is A1 and say area of cross section of tube is A2. So the volume decreased inside the oil is A1 into X, and volume increased into the tube is A2 into H. From here we can get X is equal to A2 by A1 into H. It is easily understood that magnitude of this X is very smaller than the magnitude of H, as A1 is very greater than A2. Now say applied pressure is P1 and considering pressure at the top side of the tube is P2, therefore P1 minus P2 this is equal to h plus x into rho g. In this equation, if we put the value of x, ultimately we will get p1 minus p2 is equal to rho g h into 1 plus a2 by a1. Now, as a1 is very greater than a2, so this term a2 by a1 is negligible with respect to 1. So in that case, we may write p1 minus p2 is equal to h into rho into g. In this case, rho and g are constant, so only variable term is h. So h is the indication of applied pressure. If the small leg is open to atmosphere, then this p2 is 1 atmospheric pressure. So the h indicates the gauge pressure. If two different pressures have been applied, one at well side, another one at tube, in that case, this h will indicate the differential pressure, which is the indication of difference between p1 and p2. So this is how well type manometer works for the measurement of pressure. Inclined limb or inclined tube type manometer. Construction of this manometer is same as construction of well type manometer. The difference between well type manometer here is, instead of a vertical small leg, here the small leg is inclined. Principle of operation here is same as well type manometer. Here manometer limb is inclined at an angle theta with horizontal. The effect of inclination the limb is to make the manometer more sensitive than the well type, ultimately allowing more accurate measurement at a lower range of pressure. What are small mathematical relations here? When no pressure has been applied, surface in the reservoir as well as the inclined tube was same height. Say this is the height when no pressure has been applied in the well, or we can say in the well and above this inclined tube, both pressure were same. Now the pressure to be measured, which is normally applied at well side, when that pressure will be applied, then the liquid height inside the reservoir will be decreased a little, whereas the liquid level in the inclined tube will be increased a little. So now after application of pressure, now the reference level is this and this. Say from this to this level is y, this is increased level, and here the decreased level is x. So from this to this is x. Now what is the difference of liquid height between these two is y plus x. Now considering the volume, whatever the volume has been decreased in the well, the same volume will be increased in inclined leg. So the volume decreased in reservoir is equal to A1 into x, which will be equal to, from this to this is the total length of the inclined tube filled up by extra fluid. So that D will be multiplied by the cross-sectional area of this inclined tube. So this will be A2 into D. From here, we can get the relation x is equal to a2 by a1 into d. Now here in the inclined leg, this is a right angle triangle. From this right angle triangle, as this is theta, so we know sine theta is equal to y divided by d, that is perpendicular divided by hypotenuse. From here, we can get y is equal to d into sine theta. Now say, here the applied pressure at the well is p1, and at the top of this inclined tube, say the pressure is p2. This p2 might be atmospheric pressure, might be another applied pressure. So what will be p1 minus p2? This will be balanced by height of the liquid. Now the height of the liquid here is y plus x. So this will be y plus x into rho into g. Now if we put the value of x from this equation, and y from this equation, ultimately we will get p1 minus p2 is equal to rho g d into a2 by a1 plus sine theta. In this case, theta is a constant, a2 is constant, a1 is constant, rho g both are constant, so only variable is d. So d is the indication of applied pressure. Now if this p2 means this is open to atmosphere, no doubt this d will provide indication of gas pressure. If p2 is another pressure, then this d will provide a differential pressure, which is the difference between p1 and p2. Next, explaining about barometer. Barometer is a scientific instrument used in meteorology to measure local atmospheric pressure. In general, mercury is employed in the barometer because of its higher density and a small vapor pressure at normal temperature. The barometer was invented back in 1643 by a pupil of Galileo named E. Torricelli. The barometer has a glass tube closed at one end, normally be placed invertedly into an open mercury filled reservoir. Here, at the top of this tube, normally filled up by mercury vapor and whose pressure is normally considered almost vacuum. Even if the air is completely absent inside this tube, a perfect vacuum at the top of the tube is never possible. The space would be occupied by the mercury vapor, and pressure at here is equal to the vapor pressure of mercury at its existing temperature. This almost vacuum condition above the mercury column in the barometer is known as Torricellian vacuum. Here the mercury column inside this tube will be at a steady state when this pressure created by this mercury column at this point A will be equal to the pressure applied on this mercury reservoir by the atmosphere. Mercury in the tube adjusted its height in tube until the weight of the mercury column balances the atmospheric force applied on this reservoir. High atmospheric pressure places more force on the reservoir, which forces the mercury more above in the column. This pressure is shown on the barometer's dial, usually expressed in millimeter or inches of Hg. The pressure applied by this mercury column at point A, which will be equal to the atmospheric pressure applied on the reservoir. Therefore, we can say the atmospheric pressure PATM will be equal to H rho g plus PV. What is PV? PV is the mercury vapor pressure here. Now this mercury vapor pressure PV can be neglected in comparison with atmospheric pressure, as in normal temperature, say at 20 degree centigrade, this PV is only 0.16 times atmospheric pressure. So it can be normally counted as vacuum or zero pressure. We know that the atmospheric pressure at sea level is 1.0132 into 10 to the power 5 Pascal. So if we neglect this pressure PV, then we can get H rho g is equal to atmospheric pressure, means H gives the indication of atmospheric pressure. So barometer is normally used to measure atmospheric pressure. If atmospheric pressure is high, value of H will be high. If atmospheric pressure is low, value of H will be low. If the barometer is placed at the sea level, we will get atmospheric pressure, which is normally called 1 atm, or that is 1.0132 into 10 to the power 5 Pascal. Now if we place this barometer at the top of any hilly station, then we will get less value of H, because in that place the atmospheric pressure is less. So this equation H rho g is equal to P atmosphere, therefore what will be the H? H is equal to P atmospheric pressure divided by rho into g. Now if we put the value 1.0132 into 10 to the 5 Newton per meter square, which is at sea level, value of low is 13560 kg per meter cube, and value of G is 9.81 Newton per kg. So ultimately by calculation we will get value of H is equal to 0.752 meter of Hg, which is almost equal to 760 millimeter of Hg. We normally consider that the atmosphere pressure is 760 millimeter of Hg. So this is the basic principle of operation of barometer. In this tutorial, throughout the discussion, I have tried to explain about the operation of manometer, how different types of manometers like U-tube manometer, well-type manometer, inclined limb manometer are used for the measurement of pressure. I have explained principle of operation of all the manometers with related mathematical relation. I also explained how barometer works. In next tutorial, I will enter into the discussion on elastic type pressure measuring transducer. Please subscribe, put your comments and queries in comment section.